David, the youngest son of Jesse of Jerusalem of Bethlehem, was the ideal king for Israel. He was the man who slew Goliath with a pebble in his sling. He later led the armies of Israel under King Saul, always with victory. When he and Saul had a falling out, he was something of a rebel commander for many years. When King Saul and his son Jonathan were killed by the Philistines, the tribe of Judah asked David to be their king. 2 years later, all the tribes of Israel acclaimed David as the ruler of a united Israel. He then went up to Jerusalem, which is held by the Jebusites, and conquered that city and made it the unified capital. He was also called the sweet poet of Israel because he inspired many of the psalms that we still pray today. He then brought the Ark of the Covenant up to a threshing floor, which today we call Temple Mount. And he wanted to build a temple, but God's prophet told him he had slain too many people, and it would be his son Solomon who would build the holy temple of God. In later generations, after Israel suffered many things, they longed for another King David, for a Messiah who would deliver them, would bring about right worship, and fulfill all the promises of God. Today, we commemorate that day when Jesus went up to Jerusalem and was acclaimed by the people as their Messiah and King. They threw their cloaks before him. They waved palm fronds. They shouted, "Blessed be the Son of David." I've often wondered, however, among those rejoicing crowds, were there also some who on Good Friday screamed out to Pilate, "We have no king but Caesar"? It is not enough to simply praise the Lord with our voices. We must follow him. We must be there on Holy Thursday when the Eucharist was established. We must follow him to Calvary on Good Friday when he died for our salvation. And we must be there at Easter when he rose from the dead, victorious forever, our triumphant Lord and King. Today, let us commemorate all the joy and exultation of Palm Sunday. But most of all, both the elect, those who will be baptized this Easter, and those called to be confirmed and received into the church, and all of us who may be Catholic all our lives, let us determine that we will claim Jesus not only by what we shout out, but by every decision we make in our daily lives.